Onshape's interface is streamlined and easy to use, with less icons and menus than a traditional CAD system, but all the powerful modeling tools you expect. There are several different areas that make up the interface within a document. This video describes the main aspects of the interface. The Documents toolbar at the very top displays document-level actions and information, as well as access to help documentation and account options. Starting at the left, the Onshape logo or your company logo is displayed. Clicking this navigates back to the Documents page. The Document menu allows you to rename the document, define properties, or change the units. The Version and History graph displays the actions performed in the document, and you can bookmark important entries by creating a version. The document and workspace names are displayed on the left as well. On the right side of the toolbar, you can access Comments, Notifications, the App Store, the Learning Center, and Share the document. The Help menu provides access to other documentation like the Help, What's New, the Forums, and allows you to contact Onshape support. To contact support as a customer, select Contact Support. If you are a free or educational user, select Report a Bug. Input as much information as possible into the ticket to help the support team understand the issue. Optionally, you can include a screenshot and use the tools to comment, highlight, or black out areas. You can choose to share the document with Onshape support so they can better assist you. Onshape takes the security of your data seriously, and Onshape employees do not have access to your data. If you choose to share with Onshape support, only the support team can access that document until the ticket is resolved and closed. Then the document is no longer shared with the support team. Account options are accessed by selecting the username in the top right. This menu navigates to Account Preferences, Action Items for Customers, Company Settings for Professional and Enterprise Users, and allows you to view support tickets. Below the document toolbar is the Feature, Sketch, Assembly, or Drawing toolbar. Each of these toolbars gives access to the tools available in that tab. They are context-sensitive and adjust automatically dependent on the active environment. These toolbars can be customized to your preference, allowing you to choose which tools you want available. Another way to locate features is by searching for them with the Search Tools option. Hovering over a feature displays a tooltip of how to use it, as well as a keyboard shortcut if there is one available. Several tools have keyboard shortcuts, and a complete list of keyboard shortcuts is available in the Help menu. If you want quick access to tools you use the most, the S key displays a shortcut toolbar that is context-sensitive and customizable. At the bottom, there is a tab for each Part Studio, Assembly, Drawing, or Imported file contained in the document. Click on a tab to make it active. To add more tabs, select the plus sign in the bottom left and choose the tab type you would like to create. The Tab Manager is opened by selecting the bottom left icon. This displays the tabs in another view and allows you to search and filter for certain tabs. To the left of each Part Studio or Assembly is a list. In the Part Studio, the feature list and parts list are displayed. In the Assembly, the instance list and mate features list are displayed. These lists provide the breakdown of how that part or assembly was made, which features were utilized, or which parts were inserted. These lists are explained in more detail in future courses. In the middle is the graphics area, where you can interact with the model by selecting entities or rotating the view. You can adjust the view with the mouse controls or by using the view cube and view options in the top right. Selecting a face of the view cube rotates the model to that orientation. Use the view options to go back to a standard view like isometric or adjust the display style. The feature list, instance list, and view cube can be moved in the interface by dragging and dropping to a different location. The list can also be adjusted by dragging the outside edges to make it larger or smaller. Mouse controls are a quick way to zoom, pan, and rotate the model in the graphics area. Using Onshape's default options, scrolling the middle scroll wheel of the mouse zooms in and out. Press and hold the scroll wheel of the mouse to pan the graphics area. To rotate the model, hold the right mouse button and move the mouse. The mouse cursor is the center of the zoom, pan, or rotate. However, if these controls do not feel intuitive, you can customize them by navigating to your account preferences and editing the view manipulation options. Left-clicking on a face, part, feature, or anything else selects that entity. Onshape has persistent selection, meaning as you continue to select more entities, they are added to the selection group. To deselect an entity, click on it again. To deselect all entities, click into the white space of the graphics area or press spacebar on the keyboard. Parts, sketches, curves, surfaces, instances, and other entities can be hidden or shown in the graphics area by clicking the eye icon next to that entity in the list. You might do this for a variety of reasons, including making it easier to select certain entities or visualizing internal parts in an assembly. Right-clicking in Onshape displays a context menu for that entity, giving you available options to choose based on the selection. For example, right-clicking in whitespace displays a couple view options, while right-clicking on a part displays several options for that part. Creating a new feature or editing a feature is done with a dialog. The dialog allows you to define the parameters specified to the feature. This might require keying in a value, selecting an option from a menu, toggling a reverse direction icon, checking a checkbox, or clicking an entity from the graphics area. Notice the parameter highlighted in blue is active, and new selections are added there. Notifications can appear on the top of the graphics area that provide additional direction when using certain tools. Clicking the green checkmark in a dialog accepts all edits and adds or updates that feature. If you need to undo or redo an action, just select the arrows in the top left or use the keyboard shortcut Ctrl-Z or Ctrl-Y, respectively. Clicking the red X discards any edits. Aired features are displayed in red and means a feature did not generate properly. Hovering over the feature displays a tooltip to help diagnose the issue. It is recommended you fix any aired features. Onshape's user interface has many qualities that allow you to design or innovate without restrictions or limitations of the CAD tool.